Right, lads.
See you later, bye.
Hello, love. Hello, my little sugar puff.
Daddy, there's a monster under my bed and he's gonna eat me up.
Is that right? Well, you tell that monster that your daddy's on his way home now, and if he comes out underneath your bed, I'll punch him right in the nose.
Vincent! So what time will you be home by then?
Hello, love?
Vince!
Can you still hear me? Now you're breaking up. I'll be back in a bit.
Jessica! Jessica! Hello?
Hold on, darling. Don't worry, I'll get you out. No. I'm not your daddy, love.
Daddy.
There have been some who have asked me why I do this, if there is pleasure in it for me or only pain. And it is true that mostly all I feel is alone, lost in a sea of myself. But there are brief moments when they are here with me, I am not so alone. When I look into their eyes and see them seeing me and feel their breath against my cheek, and the touch of their hand against my skin, the pulse of their life. And then the moment shatters, and I am plunged back into this darkness.
Come in.
What are you waiting for?
Can I get you a drink, Mr.?
My name's my business. And yeah, whiskey, Irish.
Why don't you take off your shoes?
Make yourself at home. I can run you a bath and you can tell me a bit about yourself.
I didn't come here for a bath and a chat. I came here for one thing and one thing only. And I think I've waited long enough. Now enough chit-chat, and let's get on with it.
Of course. As you wish, sir. The bedroom's this way.
All right, you little slut. I'm gonna show you just what you are.
Is that all that matters then? Money?
Money buys me everything I want. And having what I want makes me happy.
And what about love?
Love. Love is for fools. And for women.
Surely a man such as yourself could have any woman of his choosing.
Hmm. And you're surprised that I choose you.
Nothing surprises me, Mr. Matthews. But you do not choose me. You pay me for my services. Why pay? A man need only show his wealth to have women offering themselves free of charge.
You're right. I am a man who takes what he wants. But if I pay, I can be sure you'll do exactly as I say. An impressive collection of watches you have there. Is the idea that I'm to leave you mine as a gift?
A gift? No. I'm like you. I take what I want.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have just barged in.
It's all right, I was about to invite you in.
Perhaps I should go.
But you've only just arrived.
I'm sorry, I don't really know why I'm here.
Nor I.
You're not at all what I was expecting.
What were you expecting?
Someone less beautiful.
Thank you.
I should go.
I'd like you to stay. Why don't I fix you a drink?
All right.
Whiskey?
Yes, please. Thank you. I like your flat.
Do you? I suppose it's all right. Sometimes I like it.
And other times?
It feels like a cage.
Why, I think the whole world feels like a cage sometimes. I'm sorry, I've never done this before.
Talk to a woman?
I'm Henry.
Pleased to meet you, Henry. My name is Jezebel.
That's a beautiful name.
It means wicked.
Do you play?
Yes, I love to play. Do you?
A bit. My father taught me before he died. He was a good man when he wanted to be.
How did he die?
My mother caught him with another woman. She slit his throat and then her own. I was 9. I was so angry for such a long time. And then I realized that was all I was.
A boy filled with rage and regret. And now I don't know what I am.
I think it's better not to know. There's freedom in not knowing. There's hope. Once you know what you are, you can't escape it. It looks back at you with your eyes and speaks to you with your voice.
What could you possibly see that you don't like?
Perhaps you should go.
If I told you I loved you, would you ask me to stay?
No.
I love you.
Everything I've ever loved, I've destroyed.
Not everything.
I have tried to change, but we cannot run from what we truly are. Once I thought love would save me. But love is for fools and women. And I am neither.
just right. It's in the fishes, bite-sized and ready to eat. Take a bit from home, go and tell your mom, spread it all, spend pain, pain, pain. For better breakfast, it's Ralston. One, two, three. Shredded Ralston, the ready-to-eat bite-sized cereal. Regular Ralston and instant Ralston.
What'll you have? Thank you.
Everything okay?
His body can detect the piece of wood making its way to his heart.
The last time I saw him, he didn't look a day over 30.
Aging is a side effect.
There's nothing you can do?
We can't afford the risk to our doctors. Any invasive non-human surgery is prohibited because of the possible infection.
You don't have any of our doctors who could perform the operation?
Technically, we aren't even supposed to handle his physiology. If we move him again, the splinter could go straight to his heart and he could die instantly. It's a miracle he's lasted this long.
Miracle. What happens next?
His skin will start to flake. The monitor will detect a residual heartbeat, then it'll stop completely. You won't be able to move, and eventually it'll all go to ash.
Will there be any blood?
You've never seen this before? There usually isn't any blood unless they're in their prime or they've just eaten. He's using all the blood that we've given him, so most likely be ash. We're doing everything we can to make him comfortable.
Thank you, Doctor.
Stay as long as you want.
This isn't how I pictured dying.
How did you picture it?
I didn't. Could you grab me another pillow from over there?
At least 102.
516.
How come you never told me? The older ones practically wear it as a badge of honor.
I never thought it was really anything to brag about. It looks like you were the only one of my children who came to visit me.
Sure, it's just because the others couldn't travel as easily. Would have taken most of them more than a sunrise to get here.
In half a millennium, you were the only things that I ever did that was actually worth anything. used to watch at night as the artists created paintings and sculptures, trying to immortalize themselves in stone and canvas. And I watched just as many of those creations crumble in war after war, while some stayed protected. I don't know why certain things were preserved and others disappeared from history forever. The medium changed over and over, but the same goal remained: to live on after death. If there is one thing that I now know, it is that nothing is immortal. And that living on after death isn't all it's cracked up to be.
It has its moments.
Yeah, I remember friends that were centuries old that vanished in an instant. After everything, to go out because of a stupid accident. One would think there'd be more of a story to tell.
I'm so sorry, Philip.
Yes. It's just not the same. Could I? Just a taste.
No, we're not supposed to do that anymore.
Please.
He's arthritic. He's had a heart aneurysm for the past 15 years. No family, and he's in chronic pain. His outlook is a month tops.
What is it? Lung cancer.
good thing. Mr. Isold?
And we lived in this neighborhood where all the kids knew everybody. You know, we just a small neighborhood, and my ma knew everyone. That she knew the parents, the mom and dad, the kids, the brothers, everyone. So one Christmas, my teacher came up to us and said we're going to be in the pageant for Christmas, and we were going to sing a song. So she had us sing. And then she came up to me and said, Carl, just mouth the words, you know. I went home and told my mom, they don't want me to sing. And I felt really bad because I was the only one not singing. You know, when I was on the phone with that lady who called me?
Mrs. O'Neill.
Yeah. She didn't say, how are you gonna do it, you know?
No.
You know, I'm kind of scared. Is it gonna hurt?
She's sitting shiva with him?
We're not that far behind.
Easy for you to say, you already ate.
Fine.
thought we had a rule about souvenirs.
We do. I wanted to see what it felt like.
Don't go too soft on me. Okay? Please.
Bev.
What, are we gonna wait out here all night?
No! I don't want to do it anymore!
Mrs. Delaney? Talk for a second, please.
Go away.
What's going on?
She said to go away.
Beverly.
She said to go away.
We're predators, not angels of mercy. It's too close to sun for this crap.
Mrs. Delaney, if you don't open up the door, we're gonna break it down, you hear me? Mrs. Delaney, we're coming in whether you like it or not.
Are you okay?
No.
Are you okay?
No.
It's dead. You don't have to feel bad about it anymore.
could spend the day in the house.
We gotta make sure all the blinds are closed. We're gonna stay here all day.
Flo, please.
You have about 10 minutes to do whatever you need to do with that.
I hate this.
I have literally gone to the ends of the earth for you. I've gone against my every instinct. You want to live out here in the middle of nowhere? Fine. You want me to pretend to be Florence Nightingale? I can get behind that. But when you deny the very foundations of our existence, I don't know what to do with that. Pauline, bring that body in the house.
But it's heavy.
Pauline! Bev, the sun is coming up.
No, Beverly! No! 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 Beverly!